Oh, hello. Merry's Sunday evening. It's kind of late. And I'm pretty buzzed, but I just finished watching a movie. I'm going to review it. It was horrible, but let me talk about it. So, I have a tape, VHS, that I recorded three movies on back in like 2005, 2006, I guess. Quick and the Undead, which I reviewed. Severed, Forest of the Dead, and Night of the Dead. I just got done watching Severed, Forest of the Dead, and it was I go in to every movie I watch with high hopes, and it looks like a real movie. I could see it in the theaters. It's a zombie movie. There's a logging company has genetically engineered some sap that they inject into the trees to make them grow faster and bigger. And a logger, like these logging protesters, one of them spiked the tree. The guy's logging, his chainsaw hits the spike and it hits him in the shoulder. He turns into a zombie like within a minute. So, the infection starts. The logging company, they haven't heard from the loggers in a while, so they send one of the owners sends his son to go check up on it. And there's zombies and there's some survivors and they gotta get out of the forest. Just watching it, I was like, this is... And I thought, like, when I watched Quick and the Undead, that there weren't too many zombie movies at this time. But then I remembered, like, 28 Days Later, which seems to be, like, a big influence on this, had come out, I don't know what, 99, 2000? Land of the Dead was, like, 2004, 2005. Dawn of the Dead remake was 2005, I think. Resident Evil, we're probably on like part two already, so I guess the zombie thing was coming up. But this Severed, Forest of the Undead, yeah, it looks good, and the zombies are fine. I mean, the zombie could just look like a normal person, just throw some green paint or white paint on them. I don't care. Throw some blood on them, maybe tape some mealworms to their face, whatever you want to do. But there's like no gore in this. I was reading reviews, reading up on it, and all the kills are like, they're hacking and blood splashes on the person's face, attacking at, whatever's off screen. There's a couple of shotgun blasts, but I was like, man, there's no, for this movie, there's no iconic kill. Like, you think of Dawn of the Dead, Day of the Dead, Zombie, Brain Dead, what other, Burial Ground, Dr. Butcher MD, let me look at my, what other zombie, Ninja Zombie, there's always, like, at least one good gore kill, but there's nothing in Severed, Forest of the Dead. I kind of like the idea because they're stuck out, and a lot of the reviews were like, they could just walk out, but there's a part where they say, like, we're 200 miles from, there's a bridge that they gotta cross that's been, they boarded it up and strung barbed wire and metal, like metal braces or pylons or whatever, so they can't get through that. But then they can, they said they could hike out through the back. It's closer to civilization, I guess. So they're running through the forest. It's like a couple of the protesters and some of the loggers have banded together to survive. And then there's even a part where it reminded me of Zombie, because they go back to civilization, and they're in a lab, and the logging company where they made the zombie sap, and like a lab assistant gets infected. Then I thought, so like, is the infection gonna grow out of? But no, I guess they kill the zombie, and they kill the one that gets infected and the one person he bites, I guess. Because they just showed like the aftermath. It didn't seem like the main zombie got anywhere. So the main people in the forest, there's one dude who I thought was like gonna be the main guy, and he gets killed. But yeah, you don't see him. The zombies drag him away, and I thought they ate him. But then he becomes a zombie. Then they go deep in the forest, and they find like an encampment of loggers that have like barricaded themselves, or like made like a fort, and they've made their own little community, and they're going crazy. I like that. There's a whole outside world of normal humanity, but this little group of people, they're just like degraded, not too much, but they've like built their own little crazy society. But by that time, I was like, I just don't care anymore. I'm tuned out. Only thing that I latched onto this movie was the one. Well, there's two girls. One gets killed pretty quickly into it. I don't know. This is weird because I stopped it to go. I wanted to go get some alcoholic beverages, so I stopped it. And I was like, man, this movie is not ending. I feel like it's only an hour and a half, but it felt like 3 hours, man. But like I said, the one saving grace of Severed Forest of the Dead is the female actress Sarah Lind. I looked her up because I was like, man, this girl's like, she has like a, and I guess after a couple of zombie attacks, she has like a dazed cuteness to her. I liked her nose, I liked her cheeks. Kind of reminded me of like a not sarcastic Aubrey Plaza, like a more like a white version of Aubrey Plaza. She was one of the logging protesters, and she just was cute. That's the zone, and I just wanted her. I didn't want her to die. I must have watched this when I, dude. I must have watched. Or maybe I didn't. Maybe I just recorded it. And I was like, okay, I'll watch it in 18 years. I'll watch this because I remembered some parts, but I don't remember the end. I thought there would be some gore, but yeah, this is like a goreless zombie movie. You'll see blood. Yeah, like I said, you'll hit something, they'll splatter. You never see. There's one like gut munching scene. And someone reviewed it. It looks like they're eating Jell-O, and it did. There's no decaps. There's no like head explosions. There's no like no severed limbs. There's no like eye gouging. There's no head splitting. It's nothing. Even they get one dude. And they're eating him, and it's in the rain, it's in the dark. They eat like two dudes. You just see one guy's face. It looks like when I masturbate, and he had the like he just came face. Yeah, I just wanted it to be over, and I gotta finish it. I gotta get this out of my system. I gotta do a review of it. Sarah Lynn, though, yeah, she makes it to the end, and then the ending, like, she gets away, and then she realizes she's near a road, she sees, like, headlights go by, and she gets on the road. Okay, she's gonna get picked up, or she's gonna get run over. No, she's just walking down, like, a road in the forest, there's trees on all sides, it's raining, and then it cuts to, like, the father of the guy that they sent to check on the loggers. The son got killed, and it just shows the father like in his mansion looking at the picture of his son, and he walks down the hall and it ends. I was like, what the hell? There's no resolution. And by that, it doesn't matter. Like, man. Yeah, the only thing I... Sarah Lynn, like, I looked her up. She's born in 82, so she's, like, she's, like, 41 now. She was in a movie I watched. She was in the Humanity Bureau with Nicolas Cage. She was in Wolf Cop. A lot of TV. A couple of... Oh, God, what other... She's in something else, but she was in a... I haven't played in the back. She was in a Place to Bury Strangers video not too long ago. Maybe, like... I mean, like, 2017. I was like, wow. How did she score that? But her looks have changed. Man, I was like, did she have work done? Because she doesn't look like Aubrey Plaza anymore. She's really pretty. Yeah, I'm just... I was... The whole movie... The whole time... Like, halfway through the movie... I was like, I just like her. I don't care about... You know, it got to the point where I was like, there's not going to be any gore. It's boring. But she looked cute. She had a cool like rainbow sweater on. That jacket that she looked cute in. Like I said, her dazed look I liked. I didn't like seeing her... like in peril. But then it made me wonder, like, what kind of career? She's never been like the star of a movie. She's been in a lot of TV. I mean, kind of, she was one of the main characters in the Humanity Bureau, but she got shot in the head at the end of that. She's just like suffering through this whole zombie movie. Oh yeah, and then at the end, when the black dude's getting killed, she tells him that she's the one that spiked the tree that started the whole zombie infection. I was like, God damn you, Sarah. What the hell were you thinking? But yeah, she was the only thing I liked about this movie. Other than the fact that it looked like a real movie, it seemed like... Yeah, but also there's some cool shots of the forest, but you're not going to watch a movie just to look at the flipping forest. But if you're a Sarah Lynn fan, which I am now, just to see her when she was younger. Oh, and she's vegan. And then 2005, like, I was did I know what a vegan was in 2005? I don't think so. Yeah, there's a lot of blood, a lot of, like, hacking that you don't see, like I said. Yeah, this is a weird one to watch. I got one more zombie movie. Night of the Dead. Which I'm actually thinking is going to be the best one because it just looks horrible. It has a lot of gore, like, terrible-looking gore. Because... I was watching the tape, you know, I finished The Quick and the Undead, and then I had recorded the special features from Night of the Dead, and there it was like 30 minutes of interviews, and I was like, man, they shot a lot of, like, extras for this low budget, nothing zombie horror movie that no one's ever seen. Like, even the I don't think you can even get the DVD, and it's not on YouTube. I don't know where you could see Night of the Dead, but I might watch it right now. Actually, I think I'm going to write a letter. The Severed Forest of the Dead was a hard, hard watch. So, yeah, I'm going to give it two hands of fate, only for Sarah Lynn. I like her now. I'm a fan. I'm gonna look for her on Instagram. You should too. I'm gonna look at that Place to Bury Strangers video she did and see how she looks. And you know, happy Halloween. We're into the month of October, and hopefully, you know, we go through the highs and the lows, and I think I've hit a real low with Severed Forest of the Dead, you know. Really bad, really bad. Okay, I'll see ya.